We're standing in a 400 square foot modular farm. We use hydroponic vertical growing technology to grow year round. Our farm is basically an oversized walk-in cooler that's set on a steel frame, 10 feet high, 10 feet wide by 40 feet long, and it lets us grow a little under 4,000 plants.
Stephane Lanteigne operates Smart Green Sudbury, and he's taking a different approach to farming in Northern Ontario. He's growing vertically.
We had a terrible farming season this summer. Tons of rain, no sunlight. And so for us, the advantage is that I'm growing year round. It doesn't matter what the weather is like outside. I know that this farm is gonna stay at a nice 19 to 20 degrees Celsius. In Northern Ontario, that's huge. With only about 100 days of frost-free weather, you're kind of hard-pressed to have a go at it.
He and his family have been growing kale and sprouts in Chelmsford, Ontario, about 20 kilometers northwest of Sudbury, since April. And it's been a big hit at the local farmers market.
Our kale is unique. Hydroponic kale has a taste unlike outdoor kale. It's got a sweetness to it. And our customers, we didn't really start wanting to just farm kale, but for now, the response has been so good that we're growing it and we're selling it out every week. The beauty of the peat moss is that it retains a lot of water, eh? All our seeds are non-GMO organic certified seeds. They stay in our seedling station, which is kind of a, most people would know, a little seedling trays. We start them off as babies for about 3 weeks. And after they're about 2 or 3 inches tall, we'll transfer them to our main irrigation system with the big lights. We'll plant it and it'll stay in the towers for about 3 or 4 months. We harvest on a week to week cycle. Our lights only emit blue and reds for the most part. We don't have any green spectrum because plants don't use green spectrum. So hydroponics is all about efficiency, delivering nutrients to the root system more efficiently. So our lights are designed for growing leafy greens, and they do that very well.
His farm has a few downsides, with hydro being the biggest. He runs his lights 18 hours a day and racks up about $800 a month in electricity bills. And the startup costs for a modular farm are north of $100,000.
We're just at the beginning of what I think is going to be an agricultural revolution. There's going to be leaps and bounds and improvements in the technology. I think traditional agriculture is going to be around forever, but you can't ignore that we're quickly depleting all of our good soil. We're quickly going to be depleting all of our fresh water. Even in Canada, that's going to be an issue in the near future.
Modular Farms was created in 2015, and the systems were designed for regions like Northern Canada, where food security continues to plague communities. But it also applies to Northern Ontario, where only a small fraction of food is locally grown.
96% of their food sources was imported. So Sudbury is only producing about 4% of their food locally. Sudbury's, if you go and drive around in our agricultural land, it's a lot of it is potato. So there is very little fresh greens being grown.
Thanks to this modular farm, Stephane and his family can grow about 110 pounds of kale every week. The modular farm uses a fraction of the water a traditional farmer does to grow their crop. He can also manage the temperature, humidity, CO2 levels, and watering schedule from this control system.
I control everything on my phone, and it really allows me to dial in the farm.
Stephane and his family already have plans of expanding. They're in talks of getting a second modular farm on their property.
My business model is on a week-to-week cycle. My harvesting schedule is on a week-to-week cycle. My life is on a week-to-week cycle.
We're happy to report that they haven't just continued to produce all that produce, they're thriving. Here to update us on their operations from Chelmsford, Ontario, Stephane Lanteigne, farmer and co-owner of Truly Northern. Welcome to the show.
Hi, Dan. How are you?
Good. Now, the last time we checked in, business looks obviously a little bit different. We were talking in a 400 square foot, quote unquote, walking cooler. Tell me how things have changed since.
Not too long after, actually, we did that interview with you, we got approached by someone who had a large building in a small town about 5 hours north of Sudbury in Opus Attica. And so for the last year, we've been launching a new type of hydroponic system in there and really boosting production.
Now, we have a photo of that new facility. Let's see, there you are on your ladder. Tell us how different this looks. You look really happy. Tell us how much different is this facility to the old one?
Well, when we launched in Opus Attica, I had a very specific idea of what I wanted in a farm and how I wanted to be farming. So we did some changes to how we are doing things. We're still growing indoors. We're still doing vertical, but we're doing stacked horizontal. So multiple layers, but more traditionally positioned.
And in terms of sheer space, we're talking 400 square feet to, if I'm right, 23,000, and you haven't even filled it up yet.
So the building is huge. We're not going to be using 23,000 square feet, but that's definitely how big the building is. It's massive. We've got about 8,000 square feet of grow space. We're now at 50% and hope to be doubling our production within the next 6 months to a year.
Now, when we were chatting, of course, you were focusing exclusively on kale. Is that the same strategy here? Have you guys started to experiment with other vegetables and crops?
Yeah, with that much space on our hands, we definitely are playing a little bit more. We've now introduced lettuce mix very consistently. We've got basil. We're playing with other fresh herbs. But kale brings us back. Our new launch that we just did this week, we're doing pretty much exclusively kale. The product, just the customer base we have for it, loves it. So we're growing, we're expanding, but we're sticking to our roots too.
Now, I just want to be clear, you still have your facility in Chelmsford, and mm-hmm. you kind of have a busy schedule going back and forth, correct?
Oh yeah, that's right. So Sudbury is still our home base, and we still have our two container farms there. And we've launched kind of a self-serve shed, basically. And I drive back and forth every week, so it's been pretty busy.
What do you think has been sort of the success to your model? You guys have been, thriving, particularly in Northern Ontario when you think about farming. What do you think are some of the key successes there?
I think our product is consistently better than what you can find at the store. It's also well-priced when you're considering the freshness and the value or the taste that you're getting. All of our products are pesticide-free, and our customer base loves that. So you're getting fresh, you're getting delicious, and you're getting it year-round. So it's a local, northern-grown product, which is great.
And you've also had a lot of interest from people over the years about vertical farming, kind of been sort of the spokesperson for Northern Ontario. Tell us about kind of the calls that you've been receiving from municipalities and other businesses.
We get phone calls every week at people asking us how we're doing it, what we're doing, and we are now in a process of really expanding on that part of our business. So we're definitely interested in helping people do what we're doing, and we're excited. I think there's definitely a new movement and a new awakening to local food and the importance of producing our food locally. So I think it's going to become more and more important for us.
Any advice for people who are interested in it? I know when we talked, upfront costs was a big thing. You had talked about long hours and making this 6-hour drive back and forth. What advice are you giving people?
Indoor farming, hydroponics, outdoor—it's all farming. So you have to enjoy what you're doing. I think for us, the big benefit is that to see the people and to see the feedback we're getting from our products. So I think get into it if you really enjoy working with your hands and using your head, because it is still technically a little bit difficult. But aside from that, finding a niche and kind of finding your community that wants local food, I think it's more and more important.
One of the things we had talked about, and it's a conversation when we talk about Northern Ontario's food security. Of course, we're in the midst of a pandemic. Has COVID-19 highlighted food security in the north and the issues there?
Absolutely. I think food security has always been in the forefront in Northern Ontario. I think come around January and February, we understand food security quite well up here. Now I think people are worried even more because of the situation in the United States and our dependence on importing a lot of our food. So I think a lot of communities are waking up to the idea that we do need to roll our sleeves and to grow our own food.
One of the things in the pandemic, you know, normally this is the summer, you would be out at the farmer's market. You know, how have you adapted your business to deal with a pandemic? And I want to bring up one of the, some photos of the shed that you had brought up. This was something that you have used well before the pandemic. Tell us what we're looking at. That's a photo from the outside. And there's some great footage inside as well.
The whole idea of being like, when we launched, we wanted to have a retail customer base. So selling directly from our farm. And we started out with a freezer. It was just a little freezer that we had painted green, and we had a little space heater in there that would kick on if the weather got too cold, or the freezer itself would kick on if the weather got too hot. And that grew into now what is a ice shack that we've converted to a self-serve stand. And for us, it's been wonderful. We used to be tied to the farm with people, you know, and I say tied with love, but always having to be here to deal with customers, and that was great. But it's also nice to not have to be here all the time. So it's been a great success.
Mm-hmm. I'm curious, how does the system work? Do you just go in? Do we get to see you on the other end? How does it work?
Basically, it's a self-serve shack. Like, we have a money drop box, and all the prices are listed. It mostly works on the honor system. And we have people that will honk their horn if they have questions or if we're low on stuff. And for the most part for us, we stock the fridge 3, 4, 5 times a day when it's convenient for us, and we go.
Have you noticed anything, you know, with consumer behavior now that, you know, we are still in a pandemic? Have you seen an uptick in the number of calls about, you know, what you have available for sale?
Yeah, absolutely. I think there's been, people are buying local. There is a support local, there's a buy local, again, movement or awakening, which is great. I think local businesses, small businesses have been really impacted by COVID-19. And I think it's good that the people around you are supporting you and seeing what you're doing and seeing value there.
Have you partnered up with any local businesses to kind of give a diverse kind of array of crops and meats and stuff like that as well?
Yeah, we did. So when the pandemic first started, we very quickly pivoted online, but we, for us, saw the value in teaming up with other local producers, specifically meat producers and other artisans that, you know, have great products, share the burden of delivery. And so we are now delivering online through our online portal Order Fresh, and basically, yeah, it's been great. It's the demand has been wonderful, the support has been great, and it's nice to team up with other people and see what you can bring. It's not just about the greens, right? People want to eat a whole variety of other products too.
You know, this was something we talked about almost 3 years ago, and you had told me that you expect this to be a big thing in Northern Ontario. How far do you see this going, not just for your business, but vertical farming in Northern Ontario and beyond?
I think the technology is getting cheaper. There's quite a few of us out there that are now have been, I use the word grinding it out for the lack of a better word, for a while now. And we're seeing ways that we can really make it work. The cultivars that work for us, the amount of phone calls I'm getting from schools, from community leaders, from community business development officers that want to get into indoor farming, I think I was right 3 years ago, and I think it's only going to get bigger.
Stephane, I want to thank you so much for taking the time. That's Stephane Lanteigne, farmer and co-owner of Truly Northern. Thanks again.
Thank you.
The Agenda in the Summer with Nam Kiwanuka is brought to you by the Chartered Professional Accountants of Ontario. CPA Ontario is a regulator, an educator, a thought leader, and an advocate. We protect the public. We advance our profession. We guide our CPAs. We are CPA Ontario. And by viewers like you. Thank you.